is the GC workflow, consists of multiple steps. First, environmental samples are collected, cryopreserved, and shipped to SCGC for further processing. To give a perspective, each teaspoon of ocean water and each grain of soil contain millions of microbial cells. At SCGC, we use a fluorescence-activated cell sorter to separate microbial cells one by one into plastic microplates, each containing 384 wells. This is a highly sophisticated, automated instrument that can complete the process in a matter of a few minutes. Various fluorescent probing techniques can be used to sort very specific types of cells, either based on their taxonomy or physiology. Optical properties of each sorted cell, such as fluorescence and light scatter, are recorded and can later be matched with that particular cell's genomic sequences. Cell sorting is performed in a HEPA-filtered cleanroom environment to prevent sample contamination. Each bacterial cell contains only a one or a handful of DNA molecules. This is not sufficient for genomic sequencing with current technologies. Therefore, the next step in SCGC's workflow is whole genome amplification. We use high-performance biochemical reactions that take a single DNA molecule and accurately reproduce billions of copies of that molecule within a few hours. Robotic liquid handling is employed for contamination-free processing of thousands of individual cell reactions simultaneously. The success of genomic amplification is gauged by monitoring the fluorescence of a DNA stain in each single cell reaction. We call the product of this reaction a single amplified genome, or SAG. At this point, SAGs are ready to be analyzed for the presence of specific targeted genes or for the composition of their entire genomes. Targeted gene analysis is done using a polymerase chain reaction and subsequent amplicon sequencing. Liquid handling robotics is used to vastly increase the throughput and accuracy. Liquid handling robots are also employed to prepare DNA libraries for genomic sequencing. Library preparation involves shearing of genomic DNA into short fragments and adding molecular adapters and barcodes. When genomic libraries are ready, they are analyzed by one of SCGC's genomic sequencers. Currently, we utilize Illumina's NextSeq 500 and MiSeq instruments. Illumina's genomic sequences read the four genetic letters of millions of short DNA fragments. Each fragment is a few hundreds of nucleotides long. For comparison, a typical bacterial genome is comprised of several millions of nucleotides. Thus, the output of a genomic sequencer can be compared to a pile of jigsaw puzzle pieces. The next step in SCGC's workflow is putting this jigsaw puzzle together in order to recreate the original genome that was encoded by the single cell. Genome assembly from short DNA fragments is a very computationally demanding task. It requires advanced software and significant computational power. Equally important and challenging is the management of the highly diverse types of data that SCGC collects about each of the hundreds of thousands of cells that are analyzed by the facility. Data collection starts with a recording of field sample metadata, then continues into the recording of cells' optical properties during sorting, then proceeds into the recording of DNA amplification conditions and speed, and finally into the genomic sequencing. Customers use the data that is produced by SCGC to answer a wide array of scientific questions. For example, this data can help understanding how oceans function and are affected by human activities, how life has evolved on Earth, and how to produce new types of medicine and environment-friendly fuels.